44.5 million years ago, an extraordinary event occurred about 150 kilometers east-northeast of the city of Hull in the United Kingdom. There, a catastrophic explosion occurred equivalent in energy to the detonation of 522 megatons or 522 million tons of TNT. An asteroid had just impacted an area of the southern Dogger Bank, creating a towering tsunami wave and generating a powerful shockwave. What this energetic event during the Middle Eocene left behind was a 3.2 kilometer or 2 mile wide impact crater, which carved out an area about 250 meters or 820 feet deep. Today, this structure exists, albeit buried by thick, overlying sediments, where it is now known as Silverpit Crater. This represents the largest confirmed impact structure known in the entire United Kingdom and its vicinity. Because of the size of this impact structure, specifically its diameter, it falls into an intermediate size range where it could either theoretically have formed as a simple crater with a bowl shape or a complex crater with a central peak. In the case of Silverpit Crater, the latter is the case, meaning it is a complex impact crater. Its central peak represents a raised 1.2 kilometer wide region that was uplifted by up to 200 meters from its initial depth. But how exactly did this raised central peak form in the first place? When a large enough asteroid or comet impact occurs, it excavates a large crater that removes significant amounts of rock while also compressing underlying rock for a time and also pushing some rock towards the edge of a newly excavated area. The underlying compressed rock in the crater's center then rapidly reversed some of the compression it just experienced, causing it to rebound upwards. At the same time, the large mass of rock at the edge of the newly formed crater acts like a liquid, flowing back into the bottom of the newly formed crater. This material then collides and is forced upwards, flowing outwards until it eventually cooled and became a hardened mass, forming a central peak. So, what do we know about the impacting asteroid that created this structure? To be honest, not much. Therefore, what I am about to say is a series of plausible, albeit unproven guesses given the nature of Silverpit Crater and its surroundings at the present. Because of the crater's unusually shallow depth despite its diameter and the lack of abundant iron signatures in surrounding rocks, it suggests that the impactor had a low density. In my opinion, the asteroid likely had a density of about 3.3 grams per cubic centimeter with a composition consistent with a type L chondrite. Type L chondrites are chondrites that have a moderate metal content but a low iron content. Chondrites, for reference, are the most common and simplest type of meteorites containing many rounded grains known as chondrules that are cemented together by finer particles. In the early solar system, approximately 4.5 billion years ago, particles of rock the size of sand and cobbles merged together due to the force of gravity, forming small asteroids. I estimate that the impacting asteroid measured 219 meters or 719 feet long and had a mass of 17.9 million metric tons. This asteroid likely originated in our solar system's main asteroid belt, and when it impacted, it was traveling at a speed of 17 kilometers per second or 38,000 miles per hour. Striking the ocean at a depth of 100 meters, it caused large volumes of water to lurch upwards and be displaced, creating a towering tsunami wave that reached heights of 84 meters or 276 feet. This towering wave subsequently spread out, going on to strike ancient coastlines at a lesser height around 1 to 2 hours later. Over time, continued inward slumping of the outside of the impact crater eventually expanded to a radius of 4 kilometers. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Victor Ringel, for supporting my work.